Profoto and Phase 1 have added more functionality to the capture and lighting integration available in Capture One Pro 7. Now the aperture and ISO setting can be directly linked to the flash output level to maintain the correct exposure. To use this feature, a plugin for Capture One is needed, available from Profoto. You will also need a Profoto Air USB transceiver and a Profoto Air remote on the camera, plus compatible flash equipment from Profoto. First, download the plugin from www.profoto.com. Navigate to the path shown on screen. If your library folder is not visible, navigate to the Go menu in the Finder, hold down the Option key and choose Library. Copy the Profoto Studio bundle file to the Capture One Plugins folder. If you have Capture One open, first quit and relaunch the application. Otherwise, simply launch Capture One. Add the Light Control tool to any available tool tab. Select the corresponding channel your Profoto flash equipment is set to, and you are ready to begin working with Profoto capture and lighting integration. The lighting on this set has been designated into two groups, Group A and Group B, by setting the channel to 1A and 1B on our Pro 8A generator. These two groups represent the lights on the left and right hand side of the set. The groups can be seen in the Group pull down menu. Each group can be controlled individually by selecting them and using the increase and decrease icons here. The outer icons change the power by one stop, and the inner icons by 1/10 of a stop. Use the master option to control all lights simultaneously. The M icon turns the modelling lights on or off for selected groups, or all lights if master is selected. The next icon activates or deactivates the selected group or master. In the Link to pull down menu, choose if you wish to link the aperture or ISO to the flash output of a group or master. Therefore, when the aperture or ISO is changed on the camera, the flash output will also change to keep the exposure constant. Now you have the freedom to control depth of field whilst maintaining the correct light levels. Alternatively, the camera controls can be adjusted from within Capture One, so we can experiment with the depth of field simply by changing the aperture setting in the Camera Controls tool. Opening up the aperture has resulted in a corresponding change to the flash output. If we make a new capture, we can see that by placing our two captures side by side, that the depth of field is quite different, but the exposure level remains the same.